Hello, today I'm going to be talking about the work of the Kerala School of Mathematics and Astronomy. The topics I've listed here are just topics which are covered in the poster, which you should take a look at some point. So who are these people is the first question which arises. These people were essentially Madhava and his students. They lived in the 14th to 16th centuries roughly in Kerala. And this was also around the time, slightly before the time when major scientific revolution was going on in Europe. And so, for example, they were contemporaries or slightly earlier than Copernicus, Kepler, Newton, Leibniz and so on. So, we already know about many other Indian mathematicians such as Aryabhatta, Bhaskara and so on. So, the question that arises is, why are these people important and why have we put an entire poster on them? Previous Indian mathematicians, they were very happy just stating results without any proof or with some minimal motivation. And so the problem that arises is that you often don't know whether those results are correct or not. But these mathematicians, they seem to have a very strong focus on also proving their results in a very rigorous way. And so this is also important for historians because it gives an insight into how these mathematicians thought about these problems, what kind of techniques they used to prove different things and so on. One major problem which mathematicians have been dealing with for thousands of years is how to measure the volume of a shape, of any given shape. For example, what is the volume of a sphere? The main technique which people have been using to approximate the volume of various shapes is basically cut them into small rectangles or something, and then you add up the area of those small rectangles. For example, even Aryabhatta did this, and he just said, okay, divide the circle into 96 pieces and I give you the area of each of these pieces, which is a triangle, and then you can find the area of the circle. But these mathematicians, they basically said, okay, what happens if I divide the circle or a sphere into an infinite number of parts and then add all the volumes together? This is basically the idea behind integral calculus, which Newton and various others came up with later in Europe. The results which these people obtained, if we write them in modern notation, they are essentially what is, some of those results are given in this, on this slide. So, for example, you see that they had a formulae for the integral of a polynomial. They had a series expansion for pi, and they also knew about series expansions for various trigonometric functions like sines, cosines, tangents and so on. Another problem which was important to these people is how to calculate say the angle between two planets, or when is a planet going to enter a particular constellation, or if I know the position of the stars today, how can I calculate the date? So for all this, you basically need to be well versed in spherical trigonometry. The idea is that when you look at the night sky, it's essentially like you're looking at the inside of a sphere, and geometry on a sphere is very different from geometry on a plane. So for example, if you draw a triangle on a sphere and add up the angles, the number you will get is not 180 degree, but it is going to be more than 180 degree. And this is one of the many problems, one of the many differences between spherical trigonometry and the normal geometry on a plane. And these people were very well versed in such problems, and they gave various examples and algorithms for making such calculations. Other than the stuff I've mentioned here, there are also various other interesting results. For example, they made extensive use of mathematical induction, and one of them even came up with a model of the solar system in which the sun moves around the earth, but all the other planets move around the sun. This may be thought of as a sort of intermediate step between the geocentric model of the solar system and the heliocentric model of the solar system. And it's worth mentioning that this same model, a geo-heliocentric model, was also proposed by an astronomer called Tycho Brahe around 70 years later in Europe. However, there is no evidence that the results or knowledge that these mathematicians and astronomers had actually traveled outside of Kerala. In fact, their wisdom was basically locked up in some very old manuscripts, and only in the last 100 or 150 years they have been translated and people actually know what they have done more widely. Thank you. And of course, for more details, please, as I mentioned earlier, please feel free to look at the poster.